glad you made it, Inquisitor. I fear they've already started the ritual.
It has to be blood magic. I hope we can stop them before more people get hurt. You take point. I'll guard your backs.
Wait!
No!
Warden Commander Clarell's orders were clear.
This is wrong!
Remember your oath? In war, victory. In peace, vigilance. In death.
I'm sorry.
Sacrifice. Oh. Find it just as I showed you. Inquisitor, what an unexpected pleasure. Lord Livius Edamond de Virantium, at your service.
You are no warden.
But you are. The one Clarell let slip. And you found the Inquisitor and came to stop me. Shall we see how that goes?
Wardens, this man is lying to you. He serves an ancient Tevinter Magister who wants to unleash a blight.
That's a very serious accusation. Let's see what the Wardens think. Wardens, hands up! Hands down.
Corypheus has taken their minds.
They did this to themselves. You see, the calling had the Wardens terrified. They looked everywhere for help.
Even Tevinter.
Yes, and since it was my master who put the calling into their little heads, we in the Venatori were prepared. I went to Clarell full of sympathy, and together, we came up with a plan. Raise a demon army, march into the deep roads, and kill the old gods before they wake.
Corypheus marching across Orlais with an army of demons. That was in the future I saw at Redcliffe.
And now you know how it begins. Sadly for the Wardens, the binding ritual I taught their mages has a side effect. They are now my master's slaves. This was a test. Once the rest of the Wardens complete the ritual, the army will conquer Thedas.
So Corypheus influenced the Wardens and made them do this ritual?
Made them? No! Everything you see here, the blood sacrifices to bind the demons, the Wardens did it of their own free will. Fear is a very good motivator, and they were very afraid.
That's a lie. The Grey Wardens are heroes. They would never do this willingly.
The Grey Wardens care about nothing save stopping blights. They will do anything to accomplish that. You should have seen Clarell agonize over the decision. Burdens of command, I suppose.
Why would the Wardens try to kill the old gods?
A blight happens when Darkspawn find an old god and corrupt it into an archdemon. If someone fought through the deep roads and killed the old gods before they could be corrupted, woof! No more blights, ever. The Wardens sacrifice their lives and save the world. Although I fear history will remember them a little differently now.
Why would Clarell risk using demons?
Demons need no food, no rest, no healing. Once bound, they will never retreat, never question orders. They are the perfect army to fight through the deep roads. Or across Orlais. Now they are bound to my master.
Do you really want to see the world fall to the Blight? What do you get out of this?
The Elder One commands the Blight. He's not commanded by it, like the mindless Darkspawn. The Blight is not unstoppable or uncontrollable. It is simply a tool.
He's a tool.
As for me, while the Elder One rules from the Golden City, we, the Venatori, will be his god kings here in the world.
Release the Wardens from the binding and surrender. I won't ask twice.
No, you won't. The Elder One showed me how to deal with you in the event you're foolish enough to interfere again. That mark you bear, the anchor that lets you pass safely through the veil, you stole that from my master. He's been forced to seek other ways to access the Fade. When I bring him your head, his gratitude will be...
to listen to reason.
You were correct. Through their ritual, the mages are slaves to Corypheus.
And the Warden warriors? Of course. Sacrificed in the ritual. What a waste.
Erimond lied to the Wardens. They were trying to prevent future blights.
With blood magic and human sacrifice.
The Wardens were wrong, Hawk. But they had their reasons.
All blood mages do. Everyone has a story they tell themselves to justify bad decisions. But it never matters. In the end, you are always alone with your actions.
I believe I know where the Wardens are, Your Worship. Erimond fled in that direction. There's an abandoned Warden fortress that way. Adamant.
Good thinking.
The Warden and I will scout out Adamant and confirm that the other Wardens are there. We'll meet you back at Skyhold.
Inquisitor. Stefan finally died. It was a blessing, really. He's been in so much pain since Haven. He was out of his mind at the end. He smiled. He said he smelled his mother's turnip stew.
I hope it helps.
Inquisitor.
With allies come enemies, and now we have a place to hold them.
Your Worship, the cells are ready for the enemies of the Inquisition. Good facilities in Skyhold. Whoever built this knew how to keep prisoners safe but secure. looking good. Not good enough, but good.
Serve the Lord who loaded his catapults in mountains.
I tracked that Venatori mage back to Adamant Fortress. They're looking at assault options now in the war room.
Thanks for coming.
You did well, Varric. The Inquisitor is just who we need.
Darth, it's been great. Murderous wardens, archdemon attacks, plenty of blood mages and crazy Templars. Just like home.
I know how much you hated leaving Kirkwall.
This is the ass end of Thedas. You know they eat snails here? Still, I think I need to finish this out. If it weren't for me and Bartrand, none of this would have happened. So much for changing our lives.
That's what happens when you try to change things. Things change. You can't always control how.
Inquisitor.
Adamant Fortress has stood against the Darkspawn since the time of the Second Blight.
Fortunately for us, that means it was built before the age of modern siege equipment. A good trebuchet will do major damage to those ancient walls, and thanks to our Lady Ambassador...
Lady Ceryl of Jadar was pleased to lend the Inquisition her sappers. They've already delivered the trebuchets. That is the good news.
And the bad news?
Erimond called the ritual at the western approach a test. He may already be raising his army of demons in the fortress.
The Inquisition forces can breach the gate, but if the wardens already have their demons...
I found records of Adamant's construction. There are choke points we can use to limit the field of battle.
That's good. We may not be able to defeat them outright. But if we cut off reinforcements, we can carve you a path to Warden Commander Clarell.
Taking this fortress is going to get a lot of good soldiers killed.
Our soldiers know the risks, Inquisitor, and they know what they're fighting for.
It'll be hard fought, no way around it, but we'll get that gate open.
It's also possible that some wardens may be sympathetic to our cause. The warriors may be willing to listen to reason, though I doubt they will turn against Clarell directly. The mages, however, are slaves to Corypheus. They will fight to the death.
We've built the siege engines and readied our forces, Inquisitor. Give the word, and we march on Adamant. Have your way in. Best make use of it. We'll keep the main host of demons occupied for as long as we can.
I'll be fine. Just keep the men safe.
We'll do what we have to, Inquisitor.
Warden Stroud will guard your back. Hawk is with our soldiers on the battlements. He's assisting them until you arrive.
There's too much resistance on the walls. Our men on the ladders can't get a foothold. If you can clear out the enemies on the battlements, we'll cover your advance.
Thank you.
Turn off. We are not enemies.
Why should I trust you, Stroud? You're a traitor to the Wardens. Clorel called for your death.
The Inquisition is here to stop Clorel, not to kill Wardens. If you fall back, you won't be harmed.
All right. My men will stay back. We want no part of this. Deal with Clorel as you must. Well said. I had hoped some of the Wardens would listen to reason.
Thank you.
next one.
You can press on ahead, sir. We'll clear a path for the rest of our forces.
Stay with my forces and see that they survive this.
I'll keep the demons off them as best I can.
We need to clear a path for our guys.
Inquisitor. Our forces are ready when you are.
Wardens, we are betrayed by the very world we have sworn to protect.
The Inquisition is inside, Clarel. We have no time to stand on ceremony.
These men and women are giving their lives, Magister. That might mean little in Tavinter, but for the Wardens, it is a sacred duty. It has been many long years, my friend.
Too many, Clarel. If my sword arm can no longer serve the Wardens, then my blood will have to do.
It will.
Stop them! We must complete the ritual!
Clarel, if you complete that ritual, you're doing exactly what Erremond wants.
What? Fighting the Blight? Keeping the world safe from Darkspawn? Who wouldn't want that? And yes, the ritual requires blood sacrifice. Hate me for that if you must, but do not hate the Wardens for doing their duty!
We make the sacrifices no one else will. Our warriors die proudly for a world that will never thank them.
And then your Tavinter ally binds the mages to Corypheus!
Corypheus? But he's dead.
These people will say anything to shake your confidence, Clarel.
Bring it through!
Please! I have seen more than my share of blood magic. It is never worth the cost.
I trained half of you myself. Do not make me kill you to stop this madness!
Be ready with the ritual, Clarel. This demon is truly worthy of your strength.
Blackwall, can you talk some sense into them?
You don't know me. But you may have heard my name. Like you, I've given my life to the Grey Wardens. The first time I put on this armor, I felt like I belonged. Like I was part of something honorable. Something with a purpose. I know how good that feels. How safe. But fighting and dying here today won't stop the Blight. If you want to stop the Blight, kill that bastard up there! His master is the living embodiment of its corruption.
Clarel, we have come so far. You're the only one who can do this.
Perhaps we could test the truth of these charges to avoid more bloodshed.
Or perhaps I should bring in a more reliable ally. My master thought you might come here, Inquisitor! He sent me this to welcome you!
You've destroyed the Grey Wardens!
You did that to yourself, you stupid bitch! All I did was dangle a little power before your eyes, and you couldn't wait to get your hands bloody. You could have served a new god.
I will never serve the Blight!
Where are we? We were falling. Is this... are we dead?
No. The Inquisitor used the mark to open another rift. We fell through. I believe we're in the Fade.
The Fade looked much different the last time I was here. Perhaps it's because we're here, physically, instead of just dreaming. The stories say you walked out of the Fade at Haven. Was it like this?
I don't know. I still can't remember what happened the last time I did this.
Well, whatever happened at Haven, we can't assume we're safe now. That huge demon was right on the other side of that rift Eremond was using. And there could be others.
In our world, the rift the demons came through was nearby, in the main hall. Can we escape the same way?
It sounds like our best option. There. Let's go.
Imagine it, to walk in the Fade and survive.
We haven't survived yet.
Thank you.
That looks odd.
Something here. Let's look around. Must be something here. Let's look around.